আসসালামু আলাইকুম, আই এম ডক্টর মিন মুহিউদ্দিন ইসলাম, অ্যাসোসিয়েট প্রফেসর অফ ফার্মাকোলজি, আবদিন সকিনা ইউনুস মেডিকেল কলেজ, যশোর। নাও উইল ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট দ্য ফ্যাক্টর্স দ্যাট ইনহিবিট দ্য ইনসুলিন রিলিজ। হোয়েন উই ইউজ এক্সোজেনাস ইনসুলিন ফ্রম দ্য আউটসাইড, দ্যাট এক্সোজেনাস ইনসুলিন ইটসেলফ ইনহিবিট দ্য ইনসুলিন রিলিজ ফ্রম দ্য প্যানক্রেটিক বিটা সেল। সেকেন্ড থিং ইজ সোমাটোস্ট্যাটিন। সোমাটোস্ট্যাটিন that is the release from the delta cell of the pancreas from the islets of Langerhans. This somatostatin not only inhibit the insulin, it inhibits all the peptide hormones in our body, and in different situation it inhibits the all hormones in our body, and that's why somatostatin itself also inhibit the insulin release. Another thing of some drugs that inhibit the insulin release, that is the dioxide, phenytoin and colchicine. These are the drugs that inhibit the insulin release from the pancreatic beta cell. Dioxide is helpful in case of insulinoma. What is insulinoma? Insulinoma is a tumor that present into the pancreatic beta cell, and that pancreatic beta cell become hyperplasia due to the insulinoma and secretes excess amount of insulin. It is the pancreatic beta cell tumor which release excess amount of insulin, and this excess amount of insulin causes prolonged hypoglycemia. When he used dioxide that inhibit the insulin secretion in insulinoma, dioxide inhibit the insulin release from the pancreatic beta cell, and that's why the insulin will be not released in case of insulinoma by using the dioxide. Also phenytoin and colchicine also inhibit the release of insulin. Another thing is sympathetic nervous system activity. It causes, now the sympathetic nervous system, the postganglionic nerve fiber of the sympathetic nervous system secretes the noradrenaline, and this noradrenaline acts on the alpha 1 adrenergic system, which acts on the G protein coupled receptor and inhibits the G protein coupled receptor and inhibit the adrenyl cyclase that inhibit the ATP to not convert into the cyclic AMP. So inhibition of the cyclic AMP inhibit the insulin release from the pancreatic beta cell. But the noradrenaline, when it goes to the adrenal gland and especially into the adrenal medulla, it converts into the adrenaline. When the noradrenaline goes into the adrenal medulla and converts into adrenaline, this adrenaline acts on the beta 2 receptor of the pancreatic beta cell, which is stimulates the G protein coupled receptor in the surface, and this stimulation of adrenal cyclase, and which converts ATP into cyclic AMP very much and increase the cyclic AMP concentration, increase the release of pancreatic beta cells. So in sympathetic nervous system, the clinical significance is norepinephrine inhibit the insulin release, but epinephrine or adrenaline increase the insulin release. So noradrenaline inhibit the insulin release and epinephrine stimulate the release of insulin from the pancreatic beta cell. And there is another some clinical importance, that is the glucagon, cortisol and growth hormone. Normally the glucagon causes glycogenolysis and neogluconeogenesis in the liver, and so they produce the glucose, increase into the blood and helps to release of insulin. But when there is glucagonoma, the stimulation of the pancreatic beta cell due to release of excess glucose into the blood, the excess insulin secretion will not be released, because exhausted beta cell or overstimulation of the beta cell by the glucagon does not release the insulin. So that's why in glucagonoma they produce the type 2 diabetes mellitus. In case of cortisol, they also causes neogluconeogenesis and also glycogenolysis and increase the blood glucose level, and they causes stimulation of the pancreatic beta cell to release the insulin. But when there is overstimulation or overproduction of the cortisol due to Cushing syndrome, in Cushing syndrome the glucose will be increased and the pancreatic beta cell will be overstimulated, and the overstimulation of the pancreatic beta cell at some times later they do not release the insulin. So in case of Cushing syndrome, there will be also type 2 diabetes mellitus. In case of growth hormone, the mechanism of action of insulin is same, but overstimulation of the pancreatic beta cell in over secretion of the growth hormone in case of adult, that is the acromegaly, the insulin will not be released from the pancreatic beta cell more, and this no release of insulin cannot control the chronic hyperglycemia, and that leads to development of type 2 diabetes mellitus in hypersecretion of growth hormone, that is in acromegaly. Another clinical importance, that is the glucokinase. This is the rate limiting enzyme that causes the glucose convert into the glucose 6 phosphate, and that's why this glucose is trapped into the pancreatic beta cell. And this modification or mutation of glucokinase, this level sometimes may be mutated, or the glucokinase may be mutated, and mutation of the glucokinase produce excess glucose, produce the pancreatic beta cell glucose cannot be converted into the glucose 6 phosphate. So this excess glucose come out from the pancreatic beta cell and causes the increased level of glucose into the blood, and that causes a condition that is called the MODY, or maturity onset diabetes of the young, and this runs in families. And this the patient, they are 20 to 30 years of age, and these young children are facing the diabetes mellitus, that is the mainly we know the young adults are facing type 1 diabetes mellitus, but in this syndrome this young patient develops type 2 diabetes mellitus due to mutation of the glucokinase, and this clinical condition is called MODY, MODY, that is maturity onset diabetes of the young. So thank you all. I think you will enjoy this class and you will get benefited from this. Also expect the next class or next session will also helpful for you, because we will discuss in that part the mechanism of action of insulin and how insulin controls our blood sugar level. Thank you.